Hello and welcome everybody back to League of Ungentlemanly Warfare. Kebablot here, and this is Season 2 of Anno 1800. And yeah, the game made me do what I usually absolutely hate. It made me skip stuff between episodes. Or do stuff in between episodes, because otherwise waiting times would simply be too long. So we now have here three cotton mills that we could in theory build. But before we do that, I also need to make sure that we have the other raw material. Our goal in this episode is to create the tailored suits for our scholars. And unfortunately, we don't have a new world available, probably due to a bug or anything like that. But the expedition simply doesn't show up anymore. We have only the passage expedition. Maybe after we solve this, it will reappear again, but I don't know. Apparently the game was simply not made for having that use case. Alright, I forgot that I could by now already upgrade more of these. Leading to us having a higher scholar population. We also get a higher population in general, leading to us also getting more influence. And once all these are done, we are ready with our compass. I mean, as soon as we have the tailored suits and the seafood stew, the numbers will double anyways. And then we get our 7,000, we can then build the radio tower, and then we will get even more. So yeah, we are pretty fine by now. Okay, so for the tailored suits, we do not only need cotton, which we can thankfully now produce in the old world as well, so here, but we also need linen. Who's shooting? Okay, I don't know what happened, but hey. By the way, how much rum would we need? Only four? Well, in theory, we would need way more. And about coffee, yeah, don't get me started about that. Before we can build enough to produce everything here, we would need a way larger compass. So, we just need to have that run through around three times, and we have all these scholar residences built. Yeah, scholar residence. So, but we definitely need linen. And while we could also use our capital of Tavarim for that, we unfortunately do not have much space available for expanding the city. And that bit of space that we have, I want to use for the city itself so that we can go for the seafood stew, which is still very high on my agenda, that I'm going to do that. So, yeah, I will simply increase the city here. So, and thanks to all the paved roads, we don't have any issues with our public services and so on. Okay, that should give us a bit more shepherd workforce. But we are also going to need more milk, right? Yeah, we need more milk! More milk for our people! More milk, you get more milk. Okay, so that should cover that part, and we will of course keep the highest game speed. So we will need around 12 linen, so we need 6 of them and 12 of those. Oh, that is going to be so annoying. Nearly as annoying as the dogs outside! Yeah, just in case we're also going to build another cargo ship.
We now have the required permit to expand the campus.
Nice! Then I can soon start with getting the next one. I know that I'm now increasing the needs of all the other goods.
Ship constructed.
I need to be a bit careful here. I guess I am not even going to build those. I mean, with the amount of scholars that we have here in there already, and that should actually be enough. So what we can do, however, I mean, we can later then also get the telephones. Yeah, we will get our 7,000 people. So, meaning instead of getting off more of that, we can invest here in our fields of research.
Ready to steep myself in culture. Which subject seems the most worthy?
Might take a while until we will have everything available, but then we can simply get a few sets.
Artisanship commands respect. A true gentleman should always be penniless after visiting their barber and tailor.
The people celebrate your leadership.
Yeah, that is going to be expensive over time. But we can already build here some nice things, and we have already enough scholars that we could also start building legendary items. Which is a positive thing. Okay, so I'm probably going to hate myself once more. For doing logic puzzles that I'm not very good at, but well, someone has to do them. I can only hope that this is enough oasis to get all our linen farms, or linseed farms, up and running. Actually, seems like it.
The non-aggression pact has ended.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure Carl will sign another one with me, right?
Most promising.
Yeah. I really hope it doesn't come to me having to use tractors here. But so far, I believe they are in the green. So, we got here 4 farms already. Okay then, so now we got 8 already.
An explosion in one of your factories.
I guess we now have to wait here a little bit.
It's every person's right to change their.
A fire broke out.
Yeah, fire that will very soon be extinguished.
I love the fire service. They help me a lot.
I love the fire service as well.
The fire has been
probably not that much for fire service in Ambessa.
Ship constructed.
These colorful fields.
I try to like people a little more every day.
Okay, so I will have those suits for my tailors, for my scholars.
I can teach you how to do this if you wish.
Even if it means having to do a bit more than originally anticipated, like working that through without having the new world available. Yeah,
such
sure.
Impressive foliage, and I have you to thank.
A competitor raised a settlement.
So, next step, 8 of these. Really? As an artifact, an unflattering portrait of Arthur? Good.
I
trade route, and we call it 15 linen. On it goes. From in Sudnam here. Oh my god, I'm not even trying to pronounce it properly. I can only fail in those endeavors. So, bring me to Ketrelawney. Accept. So, and we will have to increase our storage capacities here. Otherwise, we might run into a bit of trouble. So, good thing that the lobster farms or fisheries or whatever are not standing too much in the way. Yeah, now we should be able to store here a bit more. Good. So that is the first step of what we are doing here. The next step will be to produce the required amount of wool and wood that we need. So I will later also upgrade for a fourth of these, so I will need 16 wool overproduction.
Nice day for it.
I shall keep the receipt.
We are not yet there.
To look after everyone.
Benta, where do you have so much money from? Okay, the next step will be to increase our wood production. Okay, so now we should also have a proper wood production.
Did you forget to flick the switch?
So let's see, you should go at 200% later. Processing time 30 seconds,
yeah. The and
so, and that now leads me to the question of how much cotton we are producing. At the moment we are at 6. Oh, really? Since productivity is required, that is also being put in there in the processing time, so only with electricity we get the extra 30%. I see! I don't like it! Meaning I will have to research that a bit more often, that advanced cotton mill. Okay then, but that is something we can do. At least for one time, so that we can get 8, but it will be really hard to push the limit hard enough.
Student life is unexceptional.
To get enough scholars to fully fulfill the tailored suits need. So we will need the seafood stew. I am not happy with that development. Well, hey, at least as soon as the first linen delivery comes, we'll have the first suits. And then stuff will be faster. And then we can focus on the next episode on the seafood production.
An explosion in one of your factories.
Seriously.
A fire broke out.
That was, of course, excellent timing.
Did everyone get out?
Ceasefire has ended.
Well, at least we will have soon the amount of research points that we need in order to get the next cotton fabric production before the advanced cotton mill. By now we can at least halfway fulfill the need. Yeah, as long as the incident is close by, we are going to lose scholars.
Your city has never more beautiful.
Frankly, I expected far, far more.
So, now you should be a bit happier. You should have more people in here.
The fire has been vanquished.
There's also the thing, the production of all these suits, yeah. Maintenance cost 450. I'm pretty sure the advanced cotton mill is also not very cheap. $3,000! The maintenance cost. What the? Yeah, so much about the balancing in this game. Feels just wrong.
Are we to invest in maritime, industrial, or civic technology?
Dum da dum da dum.
How about a cup of coffee?
No, there's not going to be a cup of coffee, because I want to boost our production. Miraculous steel plow. Productivity plus 50%, workforce needed, negative 50%. That would, for example, be very great in Embessa. Affects all production buildings, provides electricity. Yeah, now we are slowly getting to the real nice stuff. Affects coffee plantation. Yeah, unfortunately, I cannot build coffee farms here in Crown Falls. Super phosphate fertilizer. Also a great one. Hybrid cotton seeds. Nice. Okay then. Are you producing now? Yes, you are, meaning we are getting some tailored suits. Maybe get at least some more scholars. Yeah, I need to somehow push the limit to 40,000 for the next research, because every time we get that advanced cotton production, we need to pay like 10,000 more in research points to unlock the next one. So, without seafood stew, that will be hard. Oh, telephones. What do we need for that? Wood veneers. Yeah, for that we need the investors. Aside from that, that is actually quite an easy production line. That is fairly acceptable.
I look a little disheveled. Or is it matinee chic?
Okay, so how far is our research going? That is quite well, so we can build that soon. So, and we now need a few more artisans. Which we now have.
I'm missing particular material.
Good thing we have so many shares from Carl. Otherwise we would have severe issues.
This is nothing short of a major discovery.
We've taken to wearing.
Oh, this is going to be so expensive. In the long run. But hey. If it increases the amount of scholars that we have. Oh, come on! Come on! Just give me like 10 more! Yes, we have now the limit of 40,000, meaning as soon as we have hit that with our research points, we can research the next one, and so on, and so on, and so on. So, but that doesn't change the fact that in the next episode we are going to focus a bit more on seafood stew. So that we can have that here as well.
New orders.
So, you are the seafood stew. In the next episode we are going to increase our production on that, but we are going to create the trade route already. So, 15 seafood stew. And we start with Mbeza, Taborim, and bring it all to the I hate it that they are always switching positions! Also one of a few things that you should not do if you want to create a proper UI. But who am I to complain? I only earned my money with that for a couple of years. So there's now that. So, time to create a proper thumbnail. Hey, 4,400 scholars. We have now a limit of 41,000 research points already. That's great, meaning if we are going to create our own items, we can still on parallel identify new ones. We're definitely producing enough for that. Nice. So, those are now the old world cotton mills. And yeah, as always, I hope you enjoyed this episode. If yes, please consider giving this video a thumbs up as a little feedback for me and a small sign of appreciation. You know all the rest, right? I'm going to reposition that also here as well. Yeah, there we can place another one. So, and yeah, if you have any feedback, questions, or whatever, then just type it down in the comments. I'll make sure to read it all, and if you want to get in touch with me or the community directly, feel free to join our community Discord, for which you'll find an invitation link in the video description down below. And yeah, if you want to get notified when the next episode is being uploaded, then make sure you're subscribed to the channel and that notifications are activated. And with that, I say goodbye, and see you next time in Anno 1800 Season 2. Bye-bye!